Hey guys, my name is Flavio and I'm from Thomann. Today we're speaking about the most wanted vocal mics. We have here five microphones, the Audio-Technica, Audix, Sennheiser, T-Bone and Shure. First of all, I would like to talk about the Audix OM-7. One of the characteristics of the Audix OM-7 is the stable housing, so it's perfect for mic drops. The second characteristic that's very important about the Audix is that it eliminates probably most of the background noises. For example, in your rehearsal, if you have a small rehearsal room, this Audix is perfect because it eliminates the background sounds very good. The reason for the good vocal isolation is that the polar pattern of this Audix OM-7 is hypercardioid one. And the downside of it is that you have to be very close with your lips on the membrane to hear everything, or because if you sing left or right from the microphone, you will have some issues. I can show you. If I'm very close to the membrane, like you can see here, you hear me speaking very clear. But if I go a little bit just to the left side, you don't hear anything. Or also right side, above. Also, if I make a distance between the microphone and my lips, that singers often do when they control your voice for a louder tone or something like that, you won't hear anything. So you have to be very close to the membrane. That also means that the Audix OM-7 is very resistant against feedbacks.
Never meant to cause you sorrow. Never meant to cause you any pain. Only wanted to one time see you laughing. Only want to see you laughing in the purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. To see you bathing in the purple rain.
So the second mic we are talking about today is the Audio-Technica AE6100. What you can say about this microphone is that you don't need a lot of experimenting with the EQ because your voice will be very clear and natural, so you don't have a lot of color on your voice. I would say that the Audio-Technica is somewhere in between the Shure SM58, who is the legend between the mics, and the shown Audix OM-7. So you have also, like with the Audix OM-7, you have very good noise cancellation. That means that also on louder stage, you will be your voice will be heard very clean. But it allows singer to play a little bit with the microphone so that you can use the distance.
Like you've seen before, like when I speak with the Audix, when I was very near, you heard me talking very clear. But I can also now move a little bit back like this distance, and you will also hear me speaking. So when you sing higher notes or when you sing loud, it will allow you to play a little bit with the microphone so that you can regulate yourself how loud it will be heard on the boxes. Also, if I speak left of it and right, you will also hear a little bit of what I'm singing. It's not perfect, of course, if you're singing something, but you will hear a little bit of it.
There you can see the difference between the Audix and the Audio-Technica. There it's fully eliminated, and here you hear a little bit of it.
On this microphone, you don't need to put a key on it if you like your voice. If you don't like, you put EQ on it.
Also, one thing about the Audio-Technica AE6100 is the intelligibility of the microphone, and also that it's very balanced. It's a very balanced microphone. And yeah, I like it also a lot. Many of my colleagues use the Audio-Technica and are very satisfied because they have a very balanced and beautiful microphone.
Never meant to cause you any sorrow. Never meant to cause you any pain. I only want to see you one time, see you laughing. I only want to see you laughing in the purple rain, purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Only want to see you bathing in the purple rain.
So I would now move on to our house brand, and it's the T-Bone MB85 Beta. The first thing that I have to say about the 85 Beta is that it's the most affordable of the five ones. You have the perfect all-rounder with this microphone. A beautiful sound. It's full metal, so the microphone is very sturdy. If you're on a stage and you let it drop, you don't have to be concerned that you have damaged it. And if you have damaged it, it's no problem. You can buy a new one. It's not that expensive. Of course, if we talk about the clarity and the noise cancellation and to eliminate the background noises, of course, these ones have a clear advantage. But if you go from the all-rounder perspective of it, I would say that the T-Bone is exactly what you need.
I can speak in it if you to hear how it sounds. So you have also a marge of how much you go away with your lips from the microphone. And also if you talk right or left of it, you won't have any problems that people will hear you. Because if you recognize on TV, hold microphones like this, they don't hold it like singers in this way. So they hold it like this.
So if you are an experienced lead vocalist, want a microphone that has more clarity, like we're going to show with a Sennheiser or with a Shure. But this T-Bone so will be perfect for your background singers or for the background vocals. Also, it's a good backup.
Never meant to cause you any sorrow. Never meant to cause you any pain. Only wanted one time to see you laughing. I only want to see you laughing in the purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Only want to see you bathing in the purple rain.
So I would like to continue with the Sennheiser E945. And I don't want to favor it a lot, but it's the microphone that I'm using. That's why I'm a little bit addicted to it, because I have many gigs now played with this microphone. So I would say if you are an experienced vocalist and you are, for example, the lead vocalist of your band, this is the mic probably to go, because you will hear everything. Everything that means also if you do a mistake on stage,
the people will hear what you done. So what I like a lot of this on this microphone is it's clear, it's warm.
You have a very detailed sound so that you can hear all the pronunciations that you will do. If you sing a lot of high notes, that you will hear precisely if you hit the high notes or not, what's also very good, because if you are an experienced singer, you want the people and the crowd to hear that you're hitting the notes right. Also, I think it's very transparent. It's a beautiful, thick voice. I like it a lot. It supports my voice, so I feel comfortable with it. I would recommend for an experienced singer to go with Sennheiser, because if you know what you're doing on stage and you know you will hit all the notes right, it's the thing to go.
Never meant to cause you any sorrow. Never meant to cause you any pain. I only wanted one time to see you laughing. I only want to see you laughing in the purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Only want to see you bathing in the purple.
I don't think that I have to say a lot about the Shure SM58. It's the legend in between all of these mics. It's the first microphone that came with this metal grill. And like you can see on all the other microphones, they're all jumped on the metal grill train. And it helps a lot the vocalists of the band, the lead vocalists, because they started to go back from the mic stand and whip around with the microphone, and it eliminates all the wind noises that came. After all these years, there are a lot of musicians around the world that still swear on the Shure SM58. Year for year, there comes new microphones with more clarity, and I don't know what more extras they come, and new design, but the musicians swear on the Shure SM58. And I would say enough talking, and let's hear a little bit of the microphones and let's hear how they sound.
Didn't want to cause you any sorrow. Didn't want to cause you any pain. I only wanted one time to see you laughing. I only want to see you laughing in the purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Only want to see you bathing in the purple rain.